A lot of your marriages should be a lot further along than they are. You've wasted precious time that you can't get back.
I must say tonight that we are very much equipped. And Abby and I, we are definitely going to be working on making our marriage easier.
This went above and beyond, because you think that you have it right, and then they just add that other percentage that you know, oh, wow, that's what's missing.
You got to now take advantage of the moments that you have left. Press in. Trust God with all your heart. Stop allowing little things from the outside to just keep gnawing at your relationship. Stand up.
And now I know I can stand flat-footed on the word of God and duplicate with what Brother Mike told me.
You are the same one that says, greater is he that's in me. You're more than a conqueror, then be more than a conqueror in your marriage.
Like the application of the Bible, like everything, the structure is there. You just have to look at it and apply it and just use it for your relationship or your marriage. It's like it's all there, it's all written for you. You just have to look in, find it, and use it. Like it's the blueprint.
Shout this, my response is my responsibility. No one can make you act anyway.
For me, it was just do my part in my marriage. He says that your response is your responsibility, and so I just want to do my part and know that if I do my part, everything else will follow.
Listen to me, man. The reason why you have this emotion, anger, and frustration is because you're scared. It's a byproduct of your fear. You're always on the edge. You're always blowing your temper. You're always fussing. You can't keep things together. You're ranting and raging like a child. Simply because you're afraid. You're afraid that something isn't going to work out well, something isn't going the way it's supposed to go. And that will promote fear every single time.
And the things that he said just really blew my mind. And I didn't know that you could be in a marriage and not argue and not fight and not do the dishes and not have a baby transfer and not cry and just act a fool. And I realized that I had strayed away.
And how he never had an argument with Casey Price, who's his apostle. So why would he not have an argument with his wife? So that stuck out to me that, you know, I don't argue with my boss and people who are in authority. Why should I have an argument with my husband, who I honor and I respect? That stuck out to me the most.
One time this girl would just give me away.
Yeah.
Sell me or something.
You could just have you. I wouldn't even. You wouldn't even have to pay. Just take them. But today I'll fight you for them. I don't work too hard to train them. Now I got them just like I want them.
What I got from it basically was that I make the decisions, but my decision that I make is to do what she says.
Hey! Oh, wait till I get you home tonight.
That's right. I should get something for that, right?
Dr. Mike, Sister DeeDee, please come back to New York. We are looking forward, pretty please, we are looking forward to it.
Oh. Pastor Mike and the Dr. DeeDee, please, please, please come back. Come back. We just need you. I can see why you guys are taking it to the world, because the world is in trouble and we need you. We just need you.
Please
come back to New York. We would love to have you.
We love you guys. Please come back to New York.
Thank you for the blessing.
Thank you.
God told me that DeeDee and I would become the equivalent of a Jay-Z and a Beyonce in the body of Christ relative to marriage. Because there needs to be an attraction back to married couples in the church.